McCracken. Yeah. What? But Jill. Jill. No, Jill. Let me tell you something. I don't care. No, you're gonna have it. You're gonna have it. No, I don't care. I don't need that in my life right now. I'm not having that. Jill, you're going to have it. No. If you don't have it, I'm gonna kill myself. I'll just put a gun on my head and blow it off. Okay? No, I don't want, no, I don't care. I don't care if they're cute. No, Jill, no. We're not having this right here, okay? I got a lot of people in my office right now, okay? I got a lot of people down there, okay? Jill, I will call you. Jill, I will call you. All right. But we're not having it.
It's about 1:30 in the morning. Well, it's Saturday morning, you know, late Friday night. We're here outside the Sunoco. We're here to see somebody. Tell them who we're here to see.
Who we're here to see? I think it's simply obvious who we're here to see. The one, the only, none other than Mike Clark himself, who's in this building right now as we speak, but he doesn't know that we're here.
He doesn't know. We're going to go surprise him and see what he has to say. It's pretty cold out here.
All right, why don't we go?
Yeah, let's go inside.
But while we're going inside, why don't you listen to what Mike's teachers have to say about him?
Mike Clark had great potential. All of a sudden at the end, he just decided, I guess it wasn't the program for him. Because he had great potential, just I guess decided it wasn't for him. Good memories.
Where are the stupid people from? I think it was clear from the outset, week one, Mike had come to Algonquin with a lot of skills.
And when did you learn that?
He came to Algonquin with a lot of skills.
What did you say about Mike Clark?
Here's my phone.
Human nature!
About who?
Mike Clark.
The thing I remember most about Mike Clark is that A, he seldom showed up, and B, when he did, he was late.
Right.
It's a great memory.
Excellent.
Where is he?
Gone. Didn't make it.
Oh dear, that's too bad. I hate to see that. But, well, the problem is if you don't show up, you ain't gonna pass. That's all there is to it.
Is anybody learning from the past? We're living it going?
Good.
Do you have anything fond memories or anything? What's the best thing you liked about Mike Clark?
He had a very, very snappy wit.
For sure.
Yeah? Yeah. Is your tally light working there?
No, we haven't.
Oh, okay.
Anything else?
Do you want me to stop?
If you want.
He reminded me of my friend Rob Beckman.
Yeah? What was he like?
Who I grew up with. He's a good guy.
Yeah?
Yeah, what happened to Clarky anyway?
Just vanished, man.
Yeah? No, he's a good guy. He had a really neat sense of humor. Awesome. A little bit facetious at times.
But that word.
He did really well in my class.
Yeah? That's cool.
Are you guys making a documentary about it?
Kind of.
Yeah.
Video tribute.
What happened to Mike Clark?
Kind of. Video tribute more like it.
I called him Clarky.
Clarky.
Yeah. You remember Bobby Clark?
Yeah.
It's a funny story because when I was about 11.
Right.
Are you rolling here, Dave?
Yeah.
Because I'll tell you a story.
When I was about 11. Hi, test, this thing on? When I was about 11. My brother and I would spend like Saturday nights with my dad watching Hockey Night in Canada, right? And it was a cool thing. I'm sorry, no, you don't know that. And we'd do it. But I remember one night CBC decided during a Toronto home game with Philadelphia back then, under the Broad Street Bullets, to put microphones on the bench. Well, a penalty or something was called, and close-up shot of Bobby Clark, captain of the Philadelphia Flyers at the time. Close-up shot, microphones on the bench, he goes,
"Jesus Christ, ref, are you fucking queer?" on national TV. That was the last time there was microphones on the bench. That's my story about hockey. Okay, I gotta go home.
All right. Thanks. The Christians love their guns. The church and NRA.
Pray for their salvations. Pray on the Lord. Who is Mike Clark?
Remember the guy who used to always sit with me? He had like the goat. He had like a beard like this. And he always had the.
Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. Yes, yes. Why do you need to know the best memory of Mike Clark?
Because he's not in our program anymore, unfortunately.
Yes.
We're kind of doing a tribute to Mike Clark.
To Mike Clark?
We're interviewing everybody. Okay.
We're the last teacher we need.
The best memory of Mike Clark, well, let me see, I don't know. He was always a joker. He took some really good pictures for his first assignment. And he listened really well. Actually, he didn't. He just didn't show up at the end. His stuff was good. He was always the.
Marky, hey.
What's up, man?
Fuck,
Hi. Hi, guys.
What's up?
How are you?
Good. Yeah?
Yeah.
How
are things?
Things are okay.
Yeah?
Yeah?
How's that cigarette?
It's delicious.
How's that light, buddy?
Eric, what's your favorite position? That's cool with me, it's not my favorite, but I'll do it for you. What's your favorite dish? I'm not gonna cook it, but I'll order it from Zanzibar. And then I'm gonna love you completely. And then I fucking fuck you discreetly. And then I fucking bone you completely. But then I'm gonna fuck.
Mike was a really good guy. He was a grade or two ahead of me, and I came into the video editing room, and there he was. He was editing a video with a chicken. There was a giant chicken in this video. Mike then proceeded to undo my belt. And, well, the rest is history, but Mike, I miss you.
Mike Clark, what can I say? I remember the night we partied hard. And he didn't make it. But
what's the problem?
Oh, I'm looking at you. But I'll tell you what, Mikey was always there to.
I don't know that guy.
He's gonna come back and rise above all, and you know, make a really good comeback. But I didn't see this. So. Mike, rest in peace. We miss you.
Mike, come back.
Well, you know, I didn't know Mike Clark, but I want to.
Mike Clark? Doesn't ring a bell.
I gotta drive home with him. He had a nice book from Rolling Stones. He's a pretty nice guy. He drove us home a couple times, and he helped us out with our music video. I really appreciate it.
His mom would force us to take a bath together and his sister would come in, but that's like my fondest memory, just, you know, since then we've been.
sober. I'm not used to this temptation.
Alright, so Mr. Prosser, what do you got on your face there?
Just the leftovers from snack I had.
Yeah?
It's kind of tasty, a little sour, but...
Is that your own, or...
Something to wash that down?
Oh, yeah. Number one.
What's that, snag?
No, that's a little shower. That's a little
shower. Concentrate. Nice. Oh, you spilled some there, buddy.
I know.
So you have your own poop on your face, and you're just drinking someone else's urine. Pretty nasty. It's 1083.
I don't know. I'm trying to look up the rest. I know I left a little mess on you, but it's not too bad.
Kind of stinks.
Yeah.
Oh, sorry. So, no. I forgot to wear my deodorant today.
Well, why don't you clean that up and we'll continue this conversation.
Oh, later. Look at that. Huh?
That's pretty sick, man.
All right, I'll wash up and be right. Back.
See you later. Yeah. All right. That was Derek and his fetish.
What happened to your fish?
One of my fish died. See, I got a fish tank for Christmas. I got a fish tank for Christmas. And one of my fish died, and now there's ick in my tank. Yeah. So I'm curing it right now.
What do you mean by ick?
Ick is a sickness where the fish got spots on them. Kind of looks like salt.
Is it possible that the fishes were into scat?
Yeah, no, my fishes do like scat because they shit on each other and they eat each other's shit. It's actually true. They do like, they are into scat, you could say that.
When I think about Mike, I think about drama because Mike was always a drama king and, you know, it's... I knew it was his dream to always become a tree in the theater program, so now he can follow his dreams.
That's beautiful.
Yeah, I know. I'm sorry he had to go, but...
Plus his gayness.
Yeah, and his gayness was good, too.
Well, when he touched my ass in the cafeteria, you know?
Did it feel good?
Yeah. It's pretty sweet, you know?
Have you ever touched a dead man before?
Well, once or twice, you know, but that was the best time for sure, you know.
Mike had a special feeling.
He did. He gave me a very special feeling.
All right, my best memory of Mike would have to be when he was eating the spam and all that fun stuff in Final Production there. Yeah, when he grabbed my ass, yeah, that was a fond memory right there.
Oh, well, my fondest memory of Mike Clark would have to be the time where he was, you know, open mic, you know, that was pretty chill, you know, like his little show there. He had this attitude, you know, it's all chill, relaxed, like he didn't care about that stuff. That's cool. Too bad he's not in our class anymore, but that's life, right?
The thing I liked most about Mike was he always tried to pretend like he was organized, but he never actually had a plan. He would always, like, kind of be like, okay, we're gonna do this. And then, like, he'd show up on like, the production day, and he'd be like, okay, well, I haven't really thought of anything yet, but... I have a general idea of how it's going to turn out.
My fondest memory of Mike Clark was doing makeup for him for our final production because he was a really good sport about it, and he was a funny guy, always nice to talk to, and yeah, I liked having him around, and I'm sad he's gone.
My best memory of Mike was he was a great guest. You know, he was great to work with when I produced the Mike Check Show. You know, it was a lot of fun to work with.
Mike was when I had to pretend I was growing up Jodie Sweetin from Full House for the show that he produced in studio.
Awesome, thanks.
Hey, Bob.
Mike?
Yeah.
Mike Clark?
Yeah.
I thoroughly enjoyed Mike's creative cynicism and or sarcasm, and I think Mike is ish. And remember, Mike, watch out where the Huskies go. Don't you eat that yellow snow. So.
I miss Mike because he's my Jeopardy buddy, and we used to play Jeopardy every night on prep night. So I'm really gonna miss him because I'm gonna have to play Jeopardy alone now. It's very sad.
That's very Mike. I produced Mike's music video, and it was very interesting working with Mike. See, the problem with Mike is he has the biggest cock I've ever seen in my life. How distracting it is shooting with that. I mean, you can just fling it out and like walk around with it, and like, shit, Mike, put that crap away, man. You're making me feel bad.
Well, tell me, you have to say recording.
I love Mike like a brother. I'm really, you know, kind of upset to see him go. I think it would have been awesome to work with him, and hopefully we'll run into each other, you know, again someday. Who knows?
Mike Clark, I didn't really get to know you that long, but I saw quite a bit of your work, and personally I think that you're very talented. And I don't know, I just think that you'll still make it. I believe in you. Peace.
Canada's known for a lot of rich people, eh?
Oh yeah, we're in the rich section right here. I don't live in the rich section, personally. I live that way. And there's basically the Queensway separates, not the poor and the rich, but like the middle class and the rich. Yeah. So we're on the wrong side of the tracks here. If you don't like rich people.
Well, there was that one time, me and Mike, in back the limbo curtain, but we shouldn't go into that.
Mike, what can we say about Mike? Mike was, I don't know, spam just kind of made me sick. But it's nice to watch every, you know, keep watching that footage over time. And now I said I'm really sick this week. I don't know what else to say about Mike. Mike, the keg party is very concerned that night. He came running after me and I told him I was going to my truck and made sure I wasn't driving home. So, Mike, very responsible guy that he is, yeah.
Okay, the shows he did on are Ron's class, Mike there, I guess. Yep.
Never really worked with the guy because he's like right before me in the alphabet, so every time I had a position, then he was like one before me. So if I was in the studio, he was in the control room. Yay. Good luck.
Do you like to spit stuff out? And sing funny music?
Mike Clark is a fine individual. Great. I think he has talent that it's untapped, really.
And that's all I gotta say.
Thanks. Mike Clark. What do I remember to him?
Well, like, there's that time when we were before Frank Watcher, when I remember wrestling, right? And we were on the VTR room, and it was a prep night. And we decided to introduce Corey to the famous 98 Hound Sound Action on the ticket. Time to take a night class. Of course, Mike came to my game with us, and I got this one laugh, and he got so into it, and we were all yelling, and he's yelling, and Corey's just sitting there going, holy shit, holy shit.
Mike's like, yeah, look at this, man. No, this is what wrestling is. Now, is this awesome or what?
Okay. But how do you think?
Remember Mike?
Oh, yeah.
What's the best memory you have of him?
Oh, I gave him a bag of the peanuts, and then he grabbed it and ate them. That's all.
Can never be too safe.
You don't need a huge choice of positions to be good in bed.
I'm much tighter when I'm on my side.
And she can manage it by having one foot on the floor and still getting another leg over my shoulder.
My favourite position is the doggy position.
For me, that I'm making love to a person.
It's a deeper penetration.
Or maybe a small room.
Beforehand, without the use of condoms, you know, we live in an age of HIV.
Hey, what's up, man? Right now, we're going to take a look at Mike's music video, the video he directed for Donna's class.
And starred.
Yeah, and he was starring in that video. It's I personally think it was the best video of all the first year's music videos. It's cool. The ending is great. I think you'll like it a lot.
I think you will too. It's the video fits well with the type of song that it is, and Mike does very well in it. The direction is great, and it's just a great video. And I just want to say that this new jock protector I just bought.
Damn, this sound familiar. This sound real familiar. What remix is this?
Feeling on your booty.
What remix is this?
Feeling on your booty.
What remix is this?
Feeling on your booty.
What remix is Bill
Kyle? Alright, I always practice safe sex. Personally, my mother told me.
I thought gay men were just too hip to wear condoms. Like, we'd all wear black turtlenecks, and, you know, we'd just want to bring out a rib condom, and we'd go, ooh, how gauche.
Okay, so it'd be like a, that's it for the video. We had a good time making it and stuff, just go like that or whatever. I don't know what you're saying. What is it like for the credits, right, like the end stuff?
Yeah, thanks,
for,
yeah, okay. Thanks for watching.
That's it for the video. Thanks for watching.
Like, we had fun. We just say we had fun making it.
Good time, yeah.
Took us a long time. Like, we put it off for a long time. We took up a lot of space on those Macs or something.
But it's worth it because it's our tribute to Mike. And, you know, we miss not having him around and stuff. And we're sure you'll enjoy it, Mike. Had that? You said that?
Mm-hmm.
Or no?
Uh-oh. No food in the control room.
Yeah, no food in the control room. Sure.
Okay. I'm going to say...
Black Hawk Down is a really good movie.
So we want to thank everybody who
talked to us.
Who participated in the video. Everybody who took time out to talk to us and let us interview them.
And all the students, our classmates, the teachers, you know.
We have to thank Wade for letting us use the cameras.
Yeah, even when, like, we didn't have a booking form, he let us use it, like, just in his little area, you know, so he could keep an eye on it. So, like, we wouldn't break it in front of him, you know. So, yeah. Thanks, Wade.
And, I don't know. What else can we say?
And that's it? No, I don't know.
That's what everybody thinks of Mike.
And then when we're done, we say that's it. I'll, like, set the stand. I walk out this window about that way.
Okay. Hi. We're here. It's the end of the movie. It's the end of the video of our Mike Clark tribute, Gone But Not Forgotten. It's
mostly non-white balance, but this part is.
Yeah, we white balance in here. I hope it looks alright. I can't tell anyway.
Whatever.
We enjoyed making this video.
Him around here, you know.
Yeah.
So this is our testament to him and his legacy. Father Clint, Brad Michaels, and Ricky Rock with Poison. I think that's all chill. You enjoy watching.
See you later.
Like flavored condoms.
Why not?
For vaginal sex. This blue-eyed Leo enjoys mountain biking and skiing and likes outdoor girls who love to laugh. Everybody likes to laugh before they get raped. When you put guidelines and you put stipulations on creative freedom, that's when things go to waste. That's why I left. That's why I left.
Thank you. Is he your hair right now?
Then I took a nap.
How did you get up
at? Got up at 1. My mom's bedridden. My mom's 7 pounds. She can get it. She seems pretty chill. You have a good relationship going on.
Yeah,
sounds good.
It's not bad.
I'm a 23-year-old high school graduate, college dropout. And I'm not dropout, rejectee, I guess. I don't know. Kind of a bit of both, so I don't know. I'll go with dropout. Is kind of glad in a way, but not.
We're going to talk to him about his films and his work and I don't know what else he does.
That would be too weird!
Yeah, so I'll answer the phone. Harry Cox Sunoco.
You'll be like, what?
Harry Cox Sunoco.
Like what?
Harry Cox Sunoco.
Sorry, man.
Man. I just hear Corey. I can't see anything!
Nope. Alright. This is an application to Tim Hortons, and we wrote it in James Margerison's name, so James is applying for a job. Hopefully, James, you'll get a call.
What's up?
Alright, come on.
No, I'll just hand it off.
Sure.
Alright, thank you.
Good luck, James. See you whenever.
What the?